Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the topic that is polymer. So before we have to start the topic about the polymers, we have to see which are the learning outcomes we have to learn from that topics. So we have to learn the basic concept or knowledge about the polymers, the definition, terminology, understand the various classification or types of polymers, and the most important, the application. So we have to explain the various application of polymers in the pharmaceutical industry or manufacturing parts. So the first, the introduction of polymer. So polymers are generally used extensively, that is a broad term, in our daily routine life. We have to use daily the type of products which is made up from the polymers. In specifically for the pharmaceutical point of view, so it is widely used in the pharmaceutical dosage form, preparation of the drug delivery system, and for the research purpose also. So polymer is very much important in every aspect for the pharmaceutical field. So we have to see the examples, like the polymer is used for increasing the stability purpose of the dosage form, in specific for the drug molecules. It is also important for the solubility parameters, influencing the solubility of drug, and it is also important for the maintaining the physicochemical profile properties of the drug molecules, and for the stability also for extended period of times, and sometimes you can say that influencing the bioavailability of the drug also. So polymer, generally we have to use term synonyms similar to the plastic. So it is, so all plastics are polymers, but the fact is not all the polymers are the plastics. So the, we have to see the basic introductions parts for the polymers. So it is derived from the Greek words. Two Greek words are there, poly and meros. Poly means many and meros means the part. So polymer is a complex base structures and the giant molecules. So they have a higher molecular weight, also called as the macromolecules. And basically it is made up of hydrocarbons, made up of hydrogen and oxygen. So what is polymer? The definition parts. So polymer we can call as a substance that is composed of molecules with large molecular mass, already we have to say that contain high molecular weight, of repeatedly structural unit, generally we can call the monomers, that connected to each other by the chemical bond, that is covalent chemical bonds. So that is we can call as a polymer. And the monomer is the single unit, single part, small individuals, repeating units, molecules that you have to use in the preparation of polymer, that is monomer. So the basic history of the polymers. So in 1811, Henry that work on the cellulose, his work on the cellulose based derivatives, cellulose terminologies in 1811. In 19th century, the Leo that firstly work or created the first synthetic polymers, which is bakelite. So in 19th century, the work is going on the polymers. In 1922, Hermans that proposed the polymer consists of long chain of the atoms that is held by the covalent bond, and then further extensively works ongoing on the polymers, on addition, polymerization, chain transfer, etc. And nowadays it is widely used in every field, day to day our life we have to use the polymers. So the first one, the classification of polymers. So it is a broad or various type of classifications or types of polymers are there based on the various parameters. So we have to see one by one. So based on the composition, so they have to classify homopolymer and the hetero or copolymer. So homopolymers, so it is made up of only one type of single monomers. So polymers formed from the bonding of monomers, single base, that is called as a homopolymer. So examples, polystyrene, so it is made up of any each single polymers. Example, A is a polymer, so that is made up of only single polymers, so it is homopolymer. Copolymer, also called as heteropolymer, so it is made up of more than two different type of monomers, so it is called as a copolymers. Here examples A and B, so two different monomers are there, and then it go for the polymerization, so we can get the copolymer. So in copolymers, further classified random, alternating and the block. So different arrangement of that monomers, repeating units are there. So random polymers, so two or more different repeating units are distributed randomly. So there is no specific sequence on specific orientations are there. So A and B randomly arrangements are there. Alternating copolymer, so in this the sequence are maintaining alternate sequence of that polymers are there. Two polymers are there, A and B, so that go for the altering the arrangements. Block copolymers, so in that long sequence of each monomers are followed by the long sequence of the another one. We have to see the examples like in that A, so specific A, the long sequence of that A monomers are there, after that continuously the long sequence of the B, so that is the block copolymers. In that copolymer, another one, that is graft copolymer, so in that the side chains are there from the single parallel sequence, in that linear, at that time the branches are there. So chain made up from the one type of monomer with branch of another type. So the single linear A monomer, single chains are there, in that branching side chain the another monomers are there, that is B, so that is graft copolymer. Second, the based on the structure, previously we have to see based on the composition, then second, that is based on the structure. So in that they classified linear, so there is no branch, no side chain, cross linkings are there, so that is called the linear polymer. So it is made polymer in which molecules form the long chains without the branching or cross linking. Examples, nylon, polyester, PVC, like that. In that second, the branch polymer, so the polymer chain have branches, side chains are there, having a branch point that connect three or more chain segments are there, so that is called the branch polymer. That is example, polyethylene, starch, glycogen. In that the cross link polymers, so in that case the bonds that link one polymer chain to the another, so two sequence or linear polymer chains are there, they have to link or bond with each other with the polymer chains, so that can be covalent bond or the ionic bonds are there. So melamine formaldehyde resins are there. So nowadays cross linking polymers widely used in the every field, in the pharma field also. So linear or branch polymer also known as a thermoplastic materials, and cross link polymer known as a thermosetting materials. So in the terminologies are there polymerization, so the formation of polymer, that process we can call as a polymerization. So in is a process in which large number of small molecules, means monomers, that is combined, link or bind with each other to form a macro or large molecular weight or mass compound, with or without the elimination of that small molecules like water compounds. So that is called the polymerization process. So there are three types of polymerization process: the addition polymerization, condensation polymerization and the copolymerization. Addition polymerization also called chain growth polymerization, and condensation polymerization called the step wise polymerization. So that based on that type of polymerizations also classify the polymers, that is adhesion and condensation. The adhesion polymers, the monomers molecules, that is bind, link or bond with each other without the loss of any atoms. So that form the simple addition of monomers molecules to each other by the chain mechanism. So in that alkene monomers, biggest group that polymers in this class, example polyethylene, polystyrene, polypropylene are the example of the addition polymers. So there are basic steps for the addition polymer or any polymerization process. The three steps are there: initiation, propagation and the terminations. So what happened in that for the chain polymerization base, the sequence, that initiation, so the formation of the free radicals. So after that the combination of that monomers to form the chain, so that is propagation, and after completion the formation of polymer, so the elimination of that free radical, that is terminations. Second one in that condensation polymers. So in previous addition there is no loss of any atoms or removal of any molecules or atoms. In the condensations, when the two different monomers going for the combine or link or bond with each other, so they lose the small molecules, usually the water molecules are there. Here we have to see the examples. So the water molecules is removed from there, so this process called the condensation. So their example polyester and polyamides are the example of that condensation based polymers. Other than that, based upon the thermal response or based on the physical profiles, so elastomers are there, rubbers are there, fibers are there, and based on the upon the thermal response, we can call the thermoplastic or thermosetting polymers are there. So based on the thermal response, we have to give the heat. So plastic that softens when we have to give or apply the heat, and it becomes the foam against when cool. So this type of plastic we can call the thermoplastic, that is more popular. So because of heating and cooling, that may go for the repeated parts are there. In thermosetting plastics, so soften when the heat ends and can be molded but hardened permanently. So that is the thermosets or thermosetting plastics. So they will decompose when the reheated. Another types based on the tacticity. So what is the tacticity? So it defined as a geometric arrangement, their orientation of the characteristic group of the monomers. So in the monomers unit also, the characteristic functional groups, their orientation, their arrangement, based on that further classify the polymers with respect to that main chain backbone of the polymers. So on the basis of that tacticity, they have to classify into three groups, that is isotactic, syndiotactic, anatactic. So what is that? So in isotactic, you have to see in the polymer chain. So in that types of polymers, the characteristic groups are arranged on the same side of that main chain. So in the one side, main polymer chains are there, in that the characteristic group, the methyl groups are in the same side. So that is isotactic. Syndiotactic, so that characteristic group on the both sides. So if the side groups are arranged in alternating in both the sides, in their orientation or their face and arrangement, so that is syndiotactic polymers. In the atactic polymers, so if the alternating groups are arranged in irregular or random base orientation arrangements are there in that fashion, so that is called the atactic polymers. So has a proper strength and more elasticity compared to the previous two. So based on the origin, the source, origin source, so that we have to generally use that type of terminology in the polymer types or classification, that is natural, semi-synthetic and the synthetic. So based on the origin of source, in that natural we have to find where the source based on the nature, the plant, animal source are there. So that is called the natural polymers, the proteins, the natural rubbers are there. Semi-synthetic polymers, so mostly derived from the natural source. Further, we have to go for some chemical modification on that. Vulcanized rubbers like that. So that is based on the semi-synthetic polymers. And the synthetic polymers, so it is made up by the chemical reaction or process in the laboratory. So that is the synthetic polymers that generally we have to use, but we have to also preferable parts that nowadays the research ongoing on the use of natural polymers as compared to synthetic polymers based on the degradability. So the biodegradable and non-biodegradable we have to classify. So most important in the pharmaceutical aspects, so we have to go for the selection of biodegradable polymers. So they degrade naturally in the body, widely used PLA, polylactic acid, polyglycolic acid, polylactic acid, PEGA, polycaprolactone, PCLs, like that. So many polymers are there in that biodegradable polymers. And so many research and use of that polymers nowadays into the dosage form of drug delivery parts. Non-biodegradable polymers, they are not degraded naturally in the body. So they go for the degradation process by the chemical enzymes like that. So in that examples, that is also very much useful or important in that dosage form, preparation, formulation part, drug delivery system. So ethyl cellulose, HPMC, acrylic based polymers are there. So that are in the non-biodegradable polymers are there. So based on the type of backbone chain, so that is simply we have to classify organic, inorganic. So in that backbone chain, the carbon molecules are there, atoms are there. So that organic carbon that are not present in that backbone, other atoms or molecules are there. So that is inorganic polymer. Based on the nature, so that is we can generally use hydrophilic and hydrophobic type of that, that is water soluble and water insoluble. So generally water soluble polymers that we are using most widely in that manufacturing part. So they contain the polar charge functional groups that making that more aqueous soluble, water soluble. Examples HPMC, HPC, sodium CMC, sodium alginate, chitose and natural polymers are there. So they have to classify under the water soluble polymers. So that is used to increase the viscosity, maintain the stability of the example in that suspension, used as a adhesive parts, water soluble buccal mucosa, water soluble polymer used in the various preparation of dosage form in the suspending agents, suspension, emulsifying agent based, flocculating agents, in packaging material, coating materials. We have to go for the sustained release, control release dosage form. That times we have to use that water soluble, water insoluble type of polymers. In the hydrogel preparation, site specific targeted types, that times we have to use that water soluble, water insoluble, what type of. The next one, the characteristics, ideal characteristic of the polymer or the profile which are ideally that we have to require in the polymers for the use in any type of dosage form or drug delivery system. So it should be versatile, they possess a wide range of their mechanical strength, physical properties, chemical properties. It should be non-toxic and have good mechanical strength, easily administered, easily available, easy to formulate, fabricate, economical, chemically, physically, biologically inert, and compatible with the environment, like biological environment. So that is the ideal characteristic that we would require in the polymer for the selection base. The properties of polymers, So the physical properties of polymers, you have to require that piece strength and the flexibility. So that is dependent on the various parameter, that is chain length. So longer the chain, stronger the polymers, that generally we can call. Side group, so polar side group give the stronger attractions between the polymer chains, making them more stronger. Branching, so straight or unbranched chain can pack together more closely than highly branched chain, so it giving the polymer that are more crystalline, that go for the more stronger. Cross linking, so if polymer chains are linked together extensively by the covalent bond, the polymer is harder, more difficult to melt, it will become the stronger like that. So that these are the parameters that makes that giving the strength, flexibility of the polymers. One of the parameters, the molecular weight and the molecular weight distribution. So the knowledge of that is it is important, because there is a definite relationship between the molecular weight of the polymer and their properties. So if very low molecular weight polymers are there, so have a low mechanical properties profiles are there, solubility of polymer decrease with increasing the polymer molecular weight. So with that time you require the low molecular weight, they have a higher solubility as compared to the larger molecular weight compound polymers. And that we have to find out, calculate the average molecular weight. So we have to calculate two ways, number average molecular weight and weight average molecular weight. Mechanical properties of the polymers, so tensile strength, the elongation, elasticity, toughness, like the terminology that we have to use for the mechanical properties. The polymer resists the different stress, so can resist against the stretching, the compressions during the manufacturing process, bending, sudden stress, the loading. So with increasing the molecular weight, the polymer displays the superior properties under the applied stress. Flexible polymers can perform better under the stretching, whereas rigid polymer is better under the compression. So like that, the mechanical properties of the polymers that we have to know, which we have to, that knowledge we have to apply in the manufacturing or the formulation of that any dosage form. So the tensile strength generally we can call, so it is materials we have to apply the stress, the maximum amount of tensile strength it can take before the failure or breakdown. Elongation, the percentage elongation, like that we have to use. The change length of over the original length is called the elongation. When the elongation is high, so material is elastic, and when elongation is low, so it is a brittle type of materials are there. Elongation is a type of deformation. And what is deformation? So simply a change in the shape, that material undergoes the stress. What is the elasticity? So there is a ratio of stress over the strain, that is called the modulus of elasticity. So stress on the material increase than the strain, so it is also produced in materials until the materials go for the breakdown. And the toughness, it is measure of the energy a material can absorb before it go for the break. So like that, the properties under the mechanical parts of that. So that is the mechanical properties of the polymers. Similar like thermal properties, so the glass transition temperatures, that we have to use the terminology. So in that, so low temperatures, all the amorphous polymers that exit in the glassy state. And while in the glassy state, polymer are characterized by their hardness, their stiffness, brittleness, like that. As the temperatures we have to go for increasing or go for the rise, so that polymers go for the transition. That is known as a glass transition temperature. So where change from the glass to rubbery elastomer or flexible plastics. So in designing a control release formulations, regulatory system, it must be known whether the polymer is above or below the glass transition temperature. So that increase, so means above or below the transition temperature, glass transition, so it also affect their hardness, stiffness, permeability, their strength. So that is, we have to know that it is above or below the glass transition temperature. So polymer above are favorable above the glass transition temperature, so it is favorable for the control release formulations due to the formation of polymer chain and formation of strong intermolecular interactions. And they are control the release of the drug. So for the release of drug from the dosage form, from the drug release system, so general mechanisms, so the primary three mechanisms are there. It go for the diffusion, degradation of that polymers, that water penetration, the swelling of that polymers, followed by diffusion. So any of these mechanisms can be occur in the release system or release part of the drug. Next, the application of polymers. So it is widely used in every aspect, every parts of our daily life. It is used in various area, in medical field, pharmaceutical field, in the industry, engineering part also. But in pharmaceutical field, we have to see, generally we have to use our requirement or criteria, that is the localized or site specific delivery of drug. We have to achieve the sustained or controlled release rate from our dosage form from the drug release system. We have to stabilize, improve the stability of drug, decreasing the dosing frequency, reduce the side effect, and improve the patient compliance. These are the major parts or targets of the drug release system or dosage form. That times polymer is giving the vital role. So we have to see, mainly polymer use in the various type preparation of various type of pharmaceutical dosage forms, in like solid, semi-solid, liquid type of dosage form. Every aspect we have to use the polymers, in solid dosage form, in the tablet preparation, in the capsule preparation. We have to see the mainly use for the drug delivery system, that is the main application. In coating materials, we have to use HPMC, methyl cellulose, like that. So in the coating of the tablet, in the film coating, like that, so many polymers we have to use. In the general conventional tablets and sustained control release tablets, we have to use the various polymers. For the sustained control, we have to use water soluble, water insoluble, hydrophilic, hydrophobic, HPMC, ethyl cellulose, acrylate base, Utragit, like that polymer we have to use to achieve the sustained control release dosage form. In general conventional tablet, we have to use the binder for the tablet granulation. So that time we have to use that acacia, gelatin, sodium alginate, like that. Disintegrants, disintegrating agent we have to add in the tablet form. So that starch, HPMC, thickening agent in the preparation of suspension, increase the viscosity. Methyl cellulose we have to use. Ointment base in semi-solid part, we have to use the ointment base in the suppository base. So that is the example for the polymers. For the capsule, we have to use the gelatin. So it is a polymer, a hard gelatin capsule, soft gelatin capsule. In the suppository base also, we have to use the gelatin. In emulsifying agent, suspending agent. So these are the examples of the various dosage form drug release system where the polymer we have to use. In novel drug release system, sustained control drug release systems, we have to go for the preparation of carriers, drug carriers that go the localizer site specific targeted drug release system, and it achieve the sustained and control release type. So we have to go for microsphere preparation, micro encapsulations are there. So that time polymer we have to use. Nowadays we have to most widely use the biodegradable polymer. Packaging materials, we have to require the polymers, polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride. So like that, the applications and specific for the control delivery system. So there is a wide range every drug delivery systems we have to require one another, where the polymers are there, oral drug delivery systems are there, like osmotic drug delivery system that we have to use, the polymers, osmogens are there for the coating parts. In the gastroretentive floating type of drug delivery system, that time we have to use the polymers there to retard in the gastro part, in the stomach part only the retentions are there. We have to go for enteric coated, so we have to protect the drug or dosage from the acidic medium and the drug release on the small intestine, alkaline pH. So pH dependent polymers are there that we have to use in enteric coated. Colon targeted drug delivery systems are there. So we have to protect the drug specific into that stomach and the small intestine, and then they have to reach into the colon part at particular pH, that drugs, the polymer go for the degradation and the drug release from that dosage form. So pH dependent, time dependent, that we have to use. So many buccal, sublingual, mucosal, like that drug release systems are there. Then parenteral drug release system, parenteral control sustained release implantables are there. Ophthalmic drug release system, so in the ocular based, eye based preparations we have to go for it to achieve the sustained control. That times for designing, that time we have to use the polymers, mucosals, intranasals and pulmonary part. So through the nasal route and other respiratory tract we have to give sustained control, is target size specific. That time also we have to apply transdermal, so in that also preparing the film patch or the in situ gel like that. So that time, so drug delivery system from that skin, we have to route the route of administration, that is skin. So that times we have to use the polymers. So that is one of the approach. The other novel drug delivery system, in that the nanotechnology base, so in that parts hydrogel approach. So many examples are there for the drug delivery system where we have to use the polymer. So it is the applications of the polymers. So in that session, in the discussions, we have the conclusion is summarized. We have to see the what is polymer, the history and the basic introduction of that polymers, classification based on the different parameters we have to classify, that we have to see the classification types of polymers, the properties of the polymers, ideal characteristic of that polymers, the release mechanism from the polymers, and the applications of the polymers in the drug delivery system and the pharmaceutical upside. So these are we have to see in that session. Thank you.